Hi guys, welcome back to K-World for another episode recap of Squid Game. With the plot spoiler alert, let's get to the video. The episode starts as the pink jumpsuit staff cremate the players who died in the first game. They even seal the coffins when the eliminated players are alive. The players who got through the game sit silently in their dormitory after the shocking experience they had. Gi-hun thanks both Sung-woo and player 199 for saving his life. A group of staff come to them to announce the results. Of 456 players, only 201 have made it out alive. On seeing it, one by one beg to let them out of the game. When the masked men remind them that they could be eliminated if refused to play as for the agreement they signed, Sung-woo reminds them, according to the third statement of the agreement, the game could be cancelled if the majority agrees. So he demands to hold a vote. Before the vote, the masked man announced the prize money accumulated from the first game. The piggy bank appears, and bundles of money get dropped into it. The masked man explains, 100 million won is at stake for each player, and because 255 players got eliminated in the first game, 25.5 billion won of prize money has been accumulated into the piggy bank. If the players refuse to play, the money will be sent to the families of the eliminated players, and the ones who made it out will have to return home empty-handed. Afterwards, the players get the chance to vote for the termination of the game. The prize money has a clear effect on the players, so the votes come to a tie. The decision lies on the hand of the last voter, who is player 1, and he votes for the termination of the game. They blindfold the players and drop them off the side of the street of their neighborhood. The next day, Gi-hun goes to the police to report about the masked men and the mass murdering games they forced them to play. But none of the officers believe him, so Gi-hun furiously gives them the business card the man at the station gave him. When the officer calls the number, it gets answered by a woman. But one of the detectives seems to be interested in the story and notes the business card Gi-hun has left behind. Gi-hun goes home and looks for his mother, but she's nowhere to be found. When he goes around the neighborhood looking for her, he finds Sung-woo watching his mother from afar. Sung-woo confesses that he has 6 billion won in debt, and he has used even his mother's properties as collateral, including her house and shop. Gi-hun gets a call from the hospital, informing his mother being hospitalized. Apparently his mother has been suffering from diabetic and has left her wounds untreated. Even though the doctor insists her to get hospitalized, she leaves the hospital because neither of them can afford her hospital bills. We see the detective Hwang Jun-ho from the police station is looking for his brother. As he's on his way to his brother's apartment, he assures his mother that he will somehow find his brother. The landlady tells him that his brother didn't even pay the rent and went missing. Once Jun-ho assures her that he will settle the payment, she lets him inspect the room. He notes a business card similar to the one Gi-hun left in the police station. The girl who pickpocket Gi-hun is Kang Sae-byeok. She has a younger brother named Chol and has left him in the orphanage until she could find a way to get their parents from North Korea. When Chol tells her that he don't want to stay in the orphanage, Sae-byeok pulls him into a hug and promises him that she will get him out from there soon. The broker whom Sae-byeok has hired has fled with her money instead of getting her parents from North Korea. So the owner of the brokering service tells her to start over the process, and for that she needs to pay him 40 million won. Sae-byeok threatens the owner not to betray her again and tells him that she will bring him the money. Jun-ho, on the other hand, goes to the police station and gets the information of Gi-hun. The player 199 is named Ali. He furiously goes to see his boss and demands to pay up the wages he owes him. Ali gets into a fight with the boss and gravely injures him. He steals his money and runs off. After attacking his boss, Ali goes straight to his family. He advises them to flee to their home country and assures his wife that he will come to them once he finishes the job he has to do. Sung-woo calls his mother pretending as he's in America. As Sung-woo's mother brags about him with a customer, two detectives comes with an arrest warrant for Sung-woo. They tell her to let her son know to appear in the police station, or else it'll affect him negatively in the trial. As Sung-woo prepares to kill himself, his doorbell starts to ring continuously. When he goes to check it out, he finds a business card for the games under the door. Gi-hun, on the other hand, goes to his friend asking to lend him some money, but the friend refuses. He runs into player 1, who is Il-num, as he have a drink. Il-num joins him and tells him that he has decided to go back to the games because life out here is more tormenting. The thug who was in the game is Yoong-suk. He gets one of his minions to lend him some money. He shares with him about the games and the cash prize they have. So he wants him to get some armed men and take part in the games with him. He plans to kill and rob the masked men. Apparently Doksoo has gambling debts, which includes money he stole from his boss and minions. When he learns the minion has sold him out to the debtors, Doksoo violently attack and kill the minion. He jump off from the bridge before the debtors could get him. Gi-hun goes to ask money from his ex-wife for his mother's surgery. But she says to him that she has no money and that her husband is giving her expenses. They end up getting into an argument which her husband and children witness. Embarrassingly, Gi-hun excuses himself out of the house. Her husband follows after Gi-hun and lends him the money. In return, he asks him to stop meeting Ga-young because she is having a hard time. Enraged, he punches him on the face, which Ga-young witnesses. When Gi-hun gets home, he finds Jun-ho waiting for him by the gate. He asks about the statement he made to the police, so Gi-hun tells him that he just made it up. Jun-ho tells him that he believes his brother was taken by those masked men and asks for his help to find him. Gi-hun refuses and walks into the house. He finds a business card jammed into the door. Next, we see them all waiting for the masked man to pick them up. Knowing what exactly they're getting into, they climb into the vehicle. Sae-byeok secretly covers up her nose when the masked man fills in the gas and pretends to be unconscious. Jun-ho, on the other hand, has followed Gi-hun, and he goes after the van he's being transported. With that, the episode ends. Thanks guys for watching the video, I hope you enjoyed it. Please consider to like, subscribe, comment and share the video to help me grow the channel. See you next time.